Right, hello. Welcome to Derek's Kawasaki Z1000 SX Tourer. Just going out now, testing this new Shark Evo 1.2 Slasher, the 2020 model. I've got the Shark Tooth Bluetooth kit fitted in it. Seems very, very good. I was on the bypass a minute ago and I had a phone call and it was just so crisp clear, it was amazing, and I soon ended it. Absolutely brilliant, just two buttons. Power on, you press both buttons for 5 seconds, same as powering off, and then you've got a incoming calls can be automatic, or you can just press quick 1 second touch of the volume plus button. Same as for the end call, just quick call or just let them angle up, it doesn't matter. Anyway, let's get the show on the road, and thank you for watching, and thank you to the loyal subscribers. Yeah, I've got my bullet jeans on today, my BKS boots, shorty boots, as you can see I've got my RST gloves on. Just in case it does rain, but I doubt it. I've got my waterproofs in the cases. Very useful cases. They are 28 litres. Take a full size helmet. Quite deceiving actually. It looks like they wouldn't, but they would. Right, let's get going. And give you a review on this helmet. Just there, yeah, it's got a chin guard cover so the draft won't go down your chin. I like that, and it automatically flips back up, so we go down a bypass. We go down a bypass and then see how it goes. Yeah, I think it's it should be okay, hopefully. It should be okay, the helmet. I'm also got a new Drift Ghost XL I'm recording with. Records at 1080p, 30 frames per second. Because I had the 4K and that had a problem, so that went back to drift. I don't know what we're doing. 46, there's 50. It's not too bad. Not much wind noise, I don't think. Well, not unless the microphone picks it up. Yeah, I like the fit of the helmet. Got a sunshade on it, which I've just put down. That makes all the difference. I get to the country from here. That'd be a laugh. Yeah, straight over. Middle lane, anything coming? Yeah, the bike's running absolutely fantastic. Quite pleased with the bike. just putting the vents open, and I can feel that on me top of my crown in my head. Definitely work they do. But they're a bit cold. Now the front one, that works okay, I think. Yeah, I can feel that coming through, hitting me upper lip and my nose. Just shut that. Yeah, we're just going through Old Stoke this year. It used to be the Roots Works, but we actually changed to Peugeot, and they closed down, as you know. Famous Lumber Road Works. That's better. I didn't have the hood closed properly. Wow. I thought I could hear something on the left side. I know I'm going deaf and I use hearing aids, but something went right then. That's a lot better. I don't know if it's made a different sound in the microphone. I breathe heavy onto the pin lock. Fogs up instantly and vanishes instantly. So that's working good, definitely working good. Yeah, so so far I'm quite happy with the helmet. Thank you. Normally I get killed or knocked off my bike in this area. Yeah, the average speed cameras are along this road. Anyway, getting back to my channel. I was speaking to Steve's Hornet 900 and Bandit Nev in Australia. Because he's thinking of getting the 1-2 helmet. But I don't know if it's the Slasher like this one or just the 1-2, Evo 1-2. But if you were listening, Nev, I do like this helmet. It's a lot quieter than the LS2 and the Evo 3. Now, I know you use the Evo 3 at the moment. I've got the Evo 3 as well. And this is quite good. It really is. It is quite good, actually. What else can I say about the helmet? Yeah, the the Shark Tooth Bluetooth kit, that fitted with such ease, it was unreal. Went straight in. There's in the back of the helmet, when you take the lining out, there's a little hole there, well, not an hole, a proper cutout for the brains of the Bluetooth kit to just lift that up a minute. Yeah, the brains to fit in. The wiring isn't excessively long, so you've got minimum, and I mean minimum, about an inch or two extra to tuck in, which is nothing compared to some Bluetooth kits. And I've just gone over a big manhole. The control centre is very sleek. There's no wind drag or anything on that. There can't be, because it's smaller than your little finger. That was a bit amazing bit of kit, that. Yeah, I'm happy with that, so we just get on here. Somebody likes to think they've got a fast car in front. All it is an Audi 2-litre diesel, and he's put an R on it. Remember the days if you changed the badging on your car, you could get prosecuted because you're disguising the car. I don't like old Audis. Now ain't that a loud horn? Almost as loud as mine. Yeah, old Audis, they don't know, kick some black smoke out to do when they boot the cars because they're not looked after. Anyway, boys are down. Concentrate on what we do best, and that's riding a bike. Yeah, I don't know what it's sounding like, I hope it's okay. Now all the visors are shut. There's a slight little bit of wind today and I'm doing, there's 50 now. That's bang on 50. So I don't know what that sounds like. I hope it's clear enough because I've put a lot of money into this camera system. See, the wind there is blowing over, you can feel it. See that with the flags? Everybody speeds up here, then they slam the brakes on because the big yellow camera's around the corner. There they go, look. Braking. Doesn't matter a motorbike because it's a front facing one, they can't get your number plate. Here she is, just here, right there. A money making racket, as they used to say. I'd just like to say to Paul, Biker's Life, said I had a nice time that weekend when I come up and I've thoroughly enjoyed it. Going across the North Yorkshire Moors, excuse me, really enjoyed that, and the fish and chips outside were awesome, absolutely awesome. Let's see what this helmet's like, shall we? Nice Porsche there, old bloke driving. Well, that's the speed limit plus 10. So you know what number I'm looking at, 60 plus 10, I ain't gonna say it, but I just don't know what the helmet's like inside. It seems very quiet. Very quiet. Yeah, I like the helmet, it's a very good fit. Cheek pads are nice. You can feel them, but there's not too much pressure. Let's see if we can go a bit. Yeah, so I think I've actually found myself a real good bike that I really, really like. Capable of doing everything I want plus more. I'm not a road racer or anything like that. I never have been, never will be. I might just turn right here and go down into a yeah, I think I will. Go down the old Frosh Way. Queen's Court, come out that way. Just a ride around, just for a test of the helmet. Because I did promise certain people that I would put a video up today and definitely give you a review of it. I am happy, I really am happy with it. Down to 30. That's how warm it is, people are out in shorts. Jesus. You can find me in shorts. My legs are skinny like garden post. Lily white garden post. And the top half of me is tanned. It's amazing how it never fades. On my legs it fades, it fades after the sun, summer, and but the top half of me stays dark. Never fades. Some nice properties here. Yeah, definitely. Let's go down. Back into the National in a minute. Right now. Can't see over the brow of the hill, so just wait till it's safe. You've got a left hand bend by the looking of it, by the edge line. Yeah, definitely have. Back in, excuse me. That's the beauty of the Z1000, the power is absolutely awesome. Absolutely awesome. I thought, shit, there's a car coming. Too late, I've already committed myself. So, I wasn't going to back down, that's what I went for it. That's what you got to watch, you see, in the country. Always expect the unexpected. I find a nice little a cafe or something. Where have we got? Rugby, Leamington. Yeah, let's go right. I don't want to go to Coventry. Nah, don't want to go to Coventry. So back a minute. It is a busy road, this is. Right, and off we go. Paul, this is one of the roads I've been bringing you through when you come down to have a ride out around this area. You most probably end up going through to the Cotswolds or something as well. You'll enjoy it. Beautiful scenery up here. Why do the lorries go in when they see a puddle when you're behind them? They're just arseholes, ain't they? Arseholes driving. We've all drove lorry sometime in our life. Just browns you off, doesn't it? That skit lorry's doing faster than 30. Wee, hear it, bung. Anyway. Out. Timber yard. Smells lovely, the timber yard does. fresh cut wood. Oh yeah, you got, I don't know, yeah, the longest diner up this way. Yeah, I might call in if it's open. I think it's cash only, I don't know. Cash only, mate, we don't do cards. So what profit you make goes in your pocket and not to the taxpayers' bill. Nah, mate, that's right. Well, I know this road now, so a little bit of straight after this bend. I think there's a righty as well, right bend. And see if we can get past this lorry. After the bridge, too dangerous, too dangerous. So there's a turn in here as well, so I don't want to be taking any chances. Got a right hand bend here, and that's clear. About racing, is it? It's just about enjoying the ride and looking at the scenery and talking about the new Shark Evo 1-2 Slasher helmet in anthrac blue and black to match the bike and the RST gear. Very nice, actually. Very nice. Ditching soon. Dirty round here. The country properties are lovely, ain't they? I just love them. I'd never want one, but they're just nice. Too much maintenance in old buildings, aren't they? It's cheaper to knock them down and build a modern building. Like they have done here, look. Got even a pond there. Wow. More cost efficient, I think. I know I'm hungry. I know they don't do cards, I'm positive they don't take cards. It's my own fault. Should have brought some cash out. Might not even be open. Time we got, yeah. Midday. I don't know if the microphone's picking that up. Sound of the inline four with them rocket launcher exhausts, which I absolutely love. Some people detest them, but I love them. But everyone to themselves, isn't it? If we were all the same, it'd be a boring old wheels, wouldn't it? I think it would. Yeah, the diner's just up here on the left hand side. Mm-hmm. is there. Don't know if it's open. I'll have a look. I'll have a look. We all got to have a look, ain't we? We've got to have a look. They're open. See what I've got in pound notes. Pound notes. Pound coins. Pound coins. Right. There we go. Let's drop it down. Stop the engine. There we go. Well, I hope the always hold me right when I get off. I hope the sound's okay and the picture's all right. It's not too bright or overexposed. I've got it on normal mic setting 3 for the Drift Ghost XL, the new camera. So I'm going to go and grab a cup of tea and be back in a minute. Thank you. Bye bye. Well, is it recording? Yes, sorry about that. Just want to make sure nothing's shot in here. Oh, off we go. Just had a delicious full English breakfast, as you'll see on the photos. Whew, I'm bloated. I need this tank bag to rest my belly on. Let's just go for a ride around the countryside. Yes, that's the Longitch Diner in Longitchinson, not far from Southam in Warwickshire. Absolutely a lovely, lovely breakfast. Nice strong cup of tea. Couple of nails in the coffin as well. I know I shouldn't, but I do. Oh well. Absolutely enjoying this. Put the sun visor down. I hope it's still nice and clear. I won't be able to check till I get home. Yeah, I've got the blind spot mirrors now, the smaller ones. The other ones were too big. These are 45 millimeters, 4.5 centimeters, and they fit lovely just in the corner. What time we were running at? 1:45. I don't know if I'll have time. Can go out this way. Yeah, try and get to Gaydon if I've got time. I'm going to show you a lovely, lovely, well, I don't know what it is, it's historical. An old windmill there, no, and I mean an old type windmill. Not big, made out of stone. Always bring the kids there in the summer, as if I can remember the way. So I normally go down to 40. Down the M40 to it. Just enjoy this ride out. The sun is absolutely stonking, lovely and warm. glad I didn't put too much on, clothing wise. It would have been too hot. Twist is on this road, absolutely lovely. Remember this place actually, I might have to stop and look it up on the phone. Over to the right where I've got to go. turn right. God. It's been a long time since I've come in this way. Absolutely stunning out here. Is there a flood? No, a little one. Oh, slow down. Don't want to get the boat wet. Well, dirty, dirty. Nice hamlets out this way there is, or villages, whatever you want to call them, hamlets or villages. I think I'm on the right road, I really, really think. 20 mile an hour. We'll go right up to the end and turn and all, yeah. If I remember, because you ain't allowed in there, and that's the way you come out. Yeah. Turn right. Through the village. Yeah, how I found this place was I'm going, I think it was 2014 when I had my MGB GT. We entered the Coventry Car Festival, and it was the last actual one where they have big runouts like this. Proper old village this is, isn't it, eh? Look at it. Gorgeous, the daffodils are out. Hold on, eek. Couldn't do nothing about that. Racing around, just enjoying it. Absolutely lovely to get out on your bike and ride. Yeah, some nasty bends, aren't they? Yeah. Morrison Bassett, we turn right here. Lovely done. Quite steep that. I don't know if you can see how steep it is on the camera, but we're climbing all the time. And this is what I'm bringing you up here for. I want to show you a view. It's absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing this view is. I don't think the AirDrift will pick it up, but I can use my phone to do it. Oh, She's keeping fit, ain't she? Wow. I'd offer her a lift, but I ain't got a spare crash helmet. Ah, Derek, you sarcastic bugger. Excuse me. Yeah, look at this here. Look at that. Hey. Right. I don't know if you can see that. I've got to watch the mood on the road. That's the trouble after the winter months. You get all the mud on the road, don't you? I love this place, and the kids do. Absolutely stunning it is. Look at that. Miles and miles and miles. I'll let him go. Big gate, hold on. Now it might be a bit windy up here, but if I look that way, can you see that? It's an amazing place. Just don't know if you see all the dung around. Absolutely stunning this place is. I love it. I bring the kids here and they run for miles. Kills them off, it does. Now, I used to go out that way over there, park over there, because you can drive park anything. You can have a picnic. If I come up here, I want to take some pictures of the bike up here. There's a wild sheep there, see them? Baby ones as well, spring lambs. Yeah, you're allowed your dog. There's the toilets. Here's that windmill. Oh, they've got railings around it where it's been vandalised. But the view here, you see, as far as your eyes can see, the view's that long. Everybody comes here. Absolutely stunning. Eek, 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 eek. I think it's a dew, mate. Yeah. Just there. Just drop the kickstand down and knock her off. I'm leaving her in gear because it's very steep. Well, look at this. I don't know if you're picking this up. Goes as far as the naked eye can see. Poor biker's life, this is where I'm going to bring you, bud. I'll just have a walk up here and I'll show you what I mean. I don't know how high this is, I suppose you can Google it, the highest point, but it's an amazing place. Look at that. Look at that, and that's spectacular what we're walking up to. Look at that, eh? There's the M40 there. That's the M40. I ain't going too far down, fancy falling. But I don't know if you can pick her up. It's lovely, absolutely stunning. Look at that. I go around, big circle. Yeah, the M40. Got a church over there. Right there, you've got a church in the distance. See, it's all dunes and hills, and you stop and have your picnic, and there's benches and tables and everything. It's a lovely place, it really is. Just take some snaps of the bike. God, I'm out of breath. Old age, eh? And COPD. Not very good. Not good. Right, I'll just pull that up and over. Take a couple of snaps of me bike. It's an amazing colour. Look where it's changing colour. Be a treat here, make the bike look good. Get down level with it. I think just there. On from the back. Look at this sun, it's absolutely stonking, it is. Absolutely amazing. Hey, one from this side. One from this side on the corner. Put it in the photo album. Nice to have photos of your bike, I think. People can see what you've done into them. Frontwards. I'm on this side. A lot of people over this side now. And I want one with the windmill in it, right in it. Will I get a good one? No, I have to stand her. I have to stand her. There we go. You see them anyway, what it looks like. I think I'll put this in here. I don't know. Put a bit of music on. Quietly, so I know it's blasty red out. What we got? Downloads put together. Bang bang. Oh yeah. Well, brother, Paul, biker's life. Hope you enjoy this, because I tell you now, I think it's the best bit of scenery we got round our end. I thought that was loud. Much better. podcast better. Blasting my ears like that. You have a cigarette, I know I shouldn't. Anyway, I hope you like this part. I'm just going to have a break and show you around. Bye for now, back in a minute.